And good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to round number 4 of the PORWC Reese's Rally Car Series. As we are here today at Lime Rock here in Connecticut, getting ready for a road course race here. I believe this actually is our first road course race. No, it's our second. Watkins Glen is our first, and this is our second road course race of the season. On the point for this race is going to be Devin Smith. Alongside of him is going to be Jacob Cook. Ashley LaPlante is going to be on the inside of row number 2 alongside of, I believe that is, again, I have trouble telling these cars apart as far as these Subarus. Not exactly sure which car that is. I think it may be Hayden Klein, actually, now that I think of it. I think it is Hayden Klein. And then you've got James Silverfox. He'll line up in the inside of row number 3 alongside of Ryan Acosta. Now, the interesting thing about this race today is Dylan Ogo and Ralph Mason, who both come in only separated by 1 point in the standings, are running from mid-pack up to the back of the pack. They are not starting up near the front of the field, so they're going to have a bit of work to do to be able to leave with a good finish today and be able to either keep the points lead or take the points lead, depending on whether you're Ogo or Mason. Barney Ward's going to have to work his way up here a little bit, too. I think he's rolling off from the 9th position, our winner last week from Bristol. But without further ado, we'll get these cars rolling off. We'll show you the starting lineup as these cars will complete their pace laps, and then we'll get ready to put them under green here tonight. You can see them filing past, and it looks like Dylan Ogo is going to roll off from the 11th position. Ralph Mason, on the other hand, I think he's... Well, actually, I think he was the car rolling off ninth. Barney Ward starting in the back of the pack. It's hard to tell those two black cars apart as well. But here's your starting grid for today's race at Lime Rock. How well I remember this track. Max Skinner, the last time we were here, went flying off this hill these drivers are now coming off of. Car went airborne, and I think it was the first time we actually had a car go airborne in a Reese's Rally Car Series race like that. Max Skinner not in this field, though, so the odds of it happening to somebody else, they may happen. We'll find out as here they come. Devin Smith and Jacob Cook going to come down. They'll receive the green flag, and we are underway here at Lime Rock. Devin Smith having a tough season so far, 32nd out of 36 cars in the standings. Jacob Cook, on the other hand, they're battling on the high side. He is 4th in points, actually tied for 3rd in points with Adam Chambers, as Devin's going to try and take the early advantage here. Jacob Cook, though, hanging tough. They're 3 wide further behind them between Hayden Klein, Ryan Acosta, and Ashley LaPlante. Coming through this area here, this kind of a S turns here. And I'm hearing some squealing back there. Are the yellow lights on? Yes, they are. The caution is out. For the first time today, the caution is out here on the very first lap of this race. And look at Jacob Cook getting a run. Devin Smith got into the dirt, and that's going to slow him down. He'll lose the lead to Jacob Cook coming out of the final corner. Ashley LaPlante third. Whoa! Almost some contact there between Hayden Klein and James Silverfox. They were able to settle that out there. And Jacob Cook will lead us under the caution flag. See who was involved here. Oh, looks like Austin Ogo may have been involved. Wolfgang Mason. Lisa Shears is on pit road along with Riley Ogle, her teammate. Lisa Shears, our winner at Watkins Glen. Our winner last week, Barney Ward, is involved. Along with Sam D. Looks like a little bit of front-end damage to Wilhelm Schultz. Red Bull Citroen. I guess it's I think it's an Xara. Oh, also some damage to Zach Corbett. Trying to look up here, see a little bit further. If anybody else may have gotten a piece of it. Looks like everybody else is good to go. And there's your leader, Jacob Cook. Let's look back at a replay. We'll put us under the caution for the first time today. I'll tell you what, heading into the S's here, they were awfully backed up here. 3x3x3x3 all the way back through here, and they're going to disappear behind this hill here. Hopefully we'll get a better camera angle. Here's a good camera angle. Let's see if... Oh, Wolfgang Mason and Austin Ogle get together. They go up the hill. And then behind them, something else happens. Oh! I think it was Kyle Sanoski got turned by someone. Oh, that's further up. Whoa, hello. It's Kyle Sanoski and Lisa Shears and Riley Ogle, Barney Ward. Oh, and then Sam D just plows right into it. There's Kyle Sanoski. Wilhelm Schultz gets a piece of it. Jake Smith and Carson Gum get held up back there. Who's that blue car? Oh, that's Richard Johnson. Oh, wow, look at the damage on the Barney Ward machine. Wow. The car is all crunched up. I think he may have hit the steel guardrail right there. That can definitely tear your car apart. There's Sam D and the two Abu Dhabi cars of Riley Ogle and Lisa Shears. Oh, and there's Aaron Williams. Did Williams get a piece of it? Oh, yeah. Oh, look right here. Look at when Kyle Sanoski gets in trouble. Wilhelm Schultz hits him. Comes up into Aaron Williams, and then they collect Brock McMahon as well. And there's Joshua Michaels there in the 50. He went up on the hill, but he came back down. Whoa! 49. Brock McMahon nearly flipped over there when he ended up hitting that crest of that hill. But they go sliding here through the grass area, and the caution is out. A few drivers on pit road. Lisa Shears, our winner at Watkins Glen. Barney Ward, our winner at Bristol. As well as Lisa Shears and Sam D. It'll be interesting to see who's going to be able to continue as we go back to green. Getting ready to go back under the green flag on lap 4 of 15. Jacob Cook's the leader. Devin Smith now second. Ashley LaPlante third. Fourth, Hayden Klein. And fifth is James Silverfox. Dylan Ogo, the points leader. He's in sixth, but look who's right behind him. Second in standings, Ralph Mason. So right now, it's a two-point advantage that Dylan Ogo has over Ralph Mason in the standings. Adam Chambers, third in points, right behind them. He is eighth right now on the running chart. Michael Norman is in ninth and tenth place. That is Cody Lamas. Wow, who would have thought the drivers 1, 2, 3 in standings would be running one behind the other in 6th, 7th, and 8th on this restart. Drivers out after this latest incident that occurred are Sam D, Barney Ward, and then the two Abu Dhabi cars of Riley Ogle and Lisa Shears. So four cars of our 36 are out of the race. As the green flags back out, and Jacob Cook making short work of the field, driving away. Devin Smith nearly got turned around back there. That was a close call. Ashley LaPlante nearly getting that 29 around, and that would have been right in front of the whole field. Whoa! Both Dylan Ogo and second place Devin Smith getting into the grass there, and look at this. They're going to split three wide for second. James Silverfox making that move, but he thinks better of it. Backs off. And he'll remain behind Ashley LaPlante, who now goes into second place, taking it away from Devin Smith. You know, Devin Smith started on the pole, and now he's lost three positions in the last four laps. Hayden Klein now moving up to the third position. Good battle back here. Let's follow it. Back here with the points leader, Dylan Ogo, who has allowed Ralph Mason and Adam Chambers on past. So they could start cutting into his points lead if he's not able to get up there and challenge them once again for those positions. Dylan Ogo right now, according to the scoring monitor, would be 2 points behind Ralph Mason in our live points, but Ralph just got into the grass area. Whoa! Another car got in the grass there. But there is Ralph Mason. Michael Norman now passing him for position, and the caution's out. Caution is waving. It's for Zach Corbett and Jeremy McMurray. Zach Corbett and Jeremy McMurray getting together here and bringing out our second caution of the day as they come off the final corner. Jacob Cook, with a huge advantage, will be the leader under the caution. You bet he was the last person to want to see a caution here. Second place, Hayden Klein. Third, Ashley LaPlante. Devin Smith hangs on here, and he still will be in fourth. And Michael Norman has now cracked the top five here. As we are under the caution flag, let's look back at a replay of what happened. Take a look here. This was quite a ways back. This was around mid-pack, around the 21st position. Now, Zach Corbett already, you can see he's a damaged race car, and I think he may get a little help from Wilhelm Schultz coming off of this corner. Let's see. Is Wilhelm going to hook him right there? Yep, right there. The car gets a little loose. Wilhelm hooks him. Down he goes into Jeremy McMurray. And both those cars are going to go down here and... Oh, they missed the tire barrier there. But, oh, they're going to hit the... Oh, they're going to hit the metal chain fence! Oh, wow! That is hard impact. That chain fence doesn't have very much give to it, and oh my goodness. I think Jeremy McMurray actually flipped over there for a moment, and a hard hit for both those cars. It's enough to bring the caution flag out here for the second time today at Lime Rock. Well, good news, both Zach Corbett and Jeremy McMurray have been released from the infield care center, and there are no injuries. That was a hard hit. That's one of the things you do not want to hit here. That and the steel guardrail. If you can find a safer barrier or a tire barrier to hit, that's your best bet for not having that hard of impact and chance of injury. But right there, both those cars, very hard into that chain link fence. Jacob Cook is the leader. Second, Hayden Klein. Ashley LaPlante third. Devin Smith fourth. And Michael Norman fifth for this restart. Sixth is James Silverfox. The points leader, Dylan Ogos, worked his way back up to seventh. Right behind him, though, second in points, Ralph Mason. Right behind him, third in points, Adam Chambers in ninth. And Joshua Michaels now completes the top 10 as Devin Smith. He was the loser quite a bit on that last restart. He wants to be the gainer now. And Ashley LaPlante is way off the racetrack. Where'd she go? The disappearing Ashley LaPlante trick. There she is. Coming back on the racetrack. Oh, she gets hit by DeMarcus Brown. And around they go. Into the chain link fence once again. Will that bring out the caution flag? Oh, Brock McMahon and Zach Campbell had problems too. The caution is out. And Adam Chambers, third in the standings, is involved in something. Jacob Cook now getting challenged down low by Hayden Klein. These two may drag race it to the stripe here. Nope, Hayden Klein is going to take control of the lead now. Third leader of the race, Hayden Klein, going to come out of the final corner. And he's going to lead us down to the stripe. And he's going to take the lead under the caution flag. But Adam Chambers is involved in something. Lance Fogel is involved in something as well. He's off the pace. Jake Smith may have been in something. Oh, Wilhelm Schultz is on pit road. But there is Adam Chambers, tied for third in the standings with Jacob Cook. He's involved heavy-duty front-end damage to that NOS Mitsubishi, and we'll look back at a replay now. There must have been three or four different incidents that occurred here on lap 7. Well, here's the incident with Adam Chambers. They were all nose-to-tail here, and Joshua Michaels is going to turn Chambers around. And Chambers gets sent up straight into that tire barrier up there. Tough break right there. Just up ahead, that was the 98 of Jacob Lawler. He's going to have some contact there, but I don't think he hits anything. And then, where is DeMarcus Brown? Whoa, almost no contact there between Danny Wells and Zach Campbell. Oh, Brock McMahon gets into Zach Campbell right there. Then gets turned into him by Wolfgang Mason. And then, up further here, there is Ashley LaPlante. She's going to get hooked by DeMarcus Brown. And they're going to go spinning, and they're both going to back into that chain link fence that we saw Zach Corbett and Jeremy McMurray get into. And there you see Zach Campbell, Brock McMahon together. There's Chambers on pit road. But we also had a problem with Lance Fogel in the 90. Oh, right there. There it was. Lance Fogel, Jake Smith, Wilhelm Schultz all getting together. I think Richard Johnson may have gotten a piece of that as well right there. And oh, wait a minute. Did Wilhelm Schultz hit a tree? I think he hit a tree. Let's watch this right here. I think Wilhelm Schultz, that car just hit a tree. Right there. Oh, Lance Fogel took that corner way too sharp. Comes up into Jake Smith. And watch Wilhelm Schultz. Headed dead on for the trunk of that tree. And yes, he did. He hit the tree. Oh, and then Lance Fogel hits Wilhelm Schultz. And then Jake Smith kind of sandwiches Wilhelm Schultz between the tree and his number 25. Wilhelm Schultz, we've seen cars hit, we've had them hit steel guardrails, chain link fences. We've had them hit tire barriers, safer barriers. But never have I seen a car hit a tree. And Wilhelm Schultz just did. And that was the driver's side door. You know, there's risk of injury even if you hit a tree in a regular car. Think of it, the speeds they go here at this racetrack. Hitting driver's side door of Wilhelm Schultz possibilities. We got to definitely get an update on him, find out if he's okay. Hard hit for Wilhelm Schultz, who, yes, you heard it correctly, hit a tree. Let's go back to green. We're going to go back to green flag racing. It'll be on lap 11 of 15, giving us a total of 5 laps remaining in this event. Here's the way they line up for the restart. Hayden Klein's the leader, Jacob Cook second, Devin Smith third, fourth James Silver Fox, and the points leader Dylan Ogo. What a great run he's having right now in the fifth position. Just staying ahead of Ralph Mason, who is in sixth. Remember, those two came in today separated by only 1 point in the standings. Michael Norman is in seventh. Eighth is Justin Acosta now. And in ninth is Joshua Michaels. Cody Lamas runs in the 10th position. Back up to the front. The pace car is on pit road. There's another car on pit road there. Oh, that's Lance Fogel. Fogel is has an extended stay on pit road. But Adam Chambers has retired from this race along with Wilhelm Schultz, Zach Corbett, and Jeremy McMurray. Green flag back out here on lap number 11. Hayden Klein trying to pick up his first win of the season. Watch out, Devin Smith. He keeps on sliding up there. Whoa! Nearly got into it there with the points leader, Dylan Ogo. That could have been catastrophic. And right now, good challenge down low. As a matter of fact, the challenge is over. Jacob Cook back to the lead. As Hayden Klein slipped up through that corner, and look who's moved up to second place. James Silver Fox, all of a sudden up here in the runner-up position. He's been up in the top 10 basically this whole race, but this is the best that we've seen out of him here on this restart. Trying to run down Jacob Cook, who is definitely trying to capitalize today. He came in tied for third with Adam Chambers in the points, and Chambers, as we know, has recently retired after a hard, hard hit there after contact with Joshua Michaels, which actually brought out our third caution of the day. Jacob Cook now will be solely in control of that second, or that third position in the point standings. And how about this rage on for the points lead battle here? We got Dylan Ogo currently running in the fourth position. And right behind him, not letting that 93 out of his sights, is Ralph Mason, who just slipped up right there. Maybe he was trying too hard to catch up. And now he's under fire from Joshua Michaels. Meanwhile, up here, speaking of under fire, James Silver Fox now making the move underneath of Jacob Cook. That's for the lead. And yes, we are actually under the green flag still. That's incredible, too. These drivers have been able to keep it together now after we've had 3 straight cautions. Silver Fox, the leader now. Jacob Cook back to second. Dylan Ogo now in third place, but he's getting a challenge now for that spot by Hayden Klein. Klein wants to get back here, but Dylan Ogo, what a job by him coming alive here late in this thing. And he's now going to get a challenge for third place. As now, battle is on for the lead again. Jacob Cook wants it back from James Silver Fox. Look at him all over the back bumper, that 91. And he's going to get to the inside. Silver Fox slips up. Here comes Jacob Cook to the inside. Dylan Ogo now in this mix. How would it be for the points leader to win here today? As Silver Fox is going to slip through this corner, Jacob Cook will go back to the lead. Third time today that Jacob Cook has taken away the lead and been out in front. Jacob Cook definitely a strong car today. You'd be hard-pressed to bet against him winning this thing. He's got the dominant car right now. And Ralph Mason, remember we told you he slipped up there and was losing some spots? Well, he's gotten himself back up to the fifth position as the driver who comes in second in points. Now under fire, though, from Joshua Michaels. If I were Ralph Mason, I'd be a little worried. Oh, wait, I think the caution may be out. Is the caution out? No caution. I thought they were slowing up, but apparently not. Whoa, Jacob Cook. Yes, the caution is out. Caution is out, but it was for this time, this lap. And here comes James Silver Fox. This actually is the race for the win, guys. Whoa, watch out. Slipping up. There's Jacob Cook. Here comes James Silver Fox to the inside. Dylan Ogo right there as well. They're going to race into the stripe. The white flag will be displayed along with the caution flag. This race will be over. Silver Fox is the leader now. Dylan Ogo is taken second. Back to third is Jacob Cook. Coming down the front straightaway. No chance for Dylan Ogo. James Silver Fox wins race number 4 of the PORWC Reese's Rally Car Series. Silver Fox kind of laying in the weeds there. Made his move when it was most necessary and picks up the win. The caution, I think, may have come out for Ashley LaPlante. I do not know for certain, but I think so. Ashley LaPlante, who came in 5th in points, a tough points-paying day for her. She gets spun out there right on the... it was with 2 to go. This is the final lap. How about Dylan Ogo? No doubt about it, he will remain the points leader heading into next week at Infineon. He'll finish the day in 2nd place. And Ralph Mason, not going to be too far behind. He'll finish in the 5th position. So I think now the advantage is going to be 4 points. that Dylan Ogo will have over Ralph Mason next week. So at least Ralph Mason's able to keep Dylan Ogo within striking distance to be able to take the points lead next week, but he will not be able to take the points lead here at Lime Rock. Through the top 10, James Silver Fox with an incredible win. Second was Dylan Ogo. Third, it's going to be Jacob Cook, who undoubtedly was the most dominant car of the day. Hayden Klein will finish the day in fourth with Ralph Mason fifth. Joshua Michaels sixth. Devin Smith, the pole sitter, going to finish in a top 10 in seventh. Eighth place, Felix Harris. Where'd he come from? Ninth is going to be Ryan Acosta and his teammate, Justin Acosta. They'll finish inside the top 10. But here they come, down to the stripe. James Silver Fox is going to come down and he'll pick up his first ever PORWC Reese's Rally Car Series win. He takes the checkers at Lime Rock here today. Wow, unbelievable race. It's certainly going to be interesting to see how the points are going to get shooken up. I mean, third in the points, Adam Chambers. Fifth in the points, Astrid LaPlante. Sixth in the points, Sam D. And eighth in the points, Barney Ward. All took rather hard licks today, and they're going to fall down in the standings. That could open up an opportunity for some drivers to be able to move up inside the tasty top 10 here today after what's been an exciting 15-lap race here at Lime Rock. Hope you guys enjoyed. We head to another road course one more time, but we're going to the West Coast now. We're going to go to California and Infineon Raceway for race number 5. Hope you will tune in for that. Congratulations once again to James Silver Fox on his win here today at Lime Rock. You've been watching the PORWC Reese's Rally Car Series here on the Ancestry Sports Channel. Here comes the official finishing results and your point standings.